The call has been made by the Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom Prime Minister Andrew Byakutaga while meeting officials from the National Drug Authority, who paid a courtesy call to his office in Karuzika, Hoima City. The Premier says more than 60% of Uganda's population depends on traditional medicine because it is accessible and affordable.
Cheapest source of treatment, as they think. So even if you sell to them sowing and convince them that you will heal something, they will take it. You say this form of sowing is 1 shilling or 10 shilling, they will take that thing. So because they can't afford any the modern medication.
According to Byakutaga, enforcement officers should arrest persons selling herbal medicines without authorization from the National Drug Authority.
To us, as a center, as a cultural institution, it's important that our people, the quality of life for our people is improved. And one of the ways, of course, is to ensure that the drugs which are taken are the correct quality and the correct drugs.
Our focus is on the herbalist medicine that they make,
yeah,
and they give out to the public. We want to teach them, educate them on how best to store such.
Mm.
But the practice issues are not managed by the associations.
Zake Kalega from the National Drug Authority admits that there are a number of interventions set by the government to handle this issue of herbalists.
What the government is doing now, all measures now are promoting our local production. And as I must say, there are some essential drugs that government is even good to ban import, so that the local manufacturers can now build capacity. Those are some of the measures that we are taking. Even the national government plan is looking at promotion of local pharmaceutical industries.
I think, though, that the biggest challenge arises at the service delivery levels, hospitals, clinics, and that's where perhaps the inflation of the costs of healthcare come in. Of course, the government has spoken about the insurance, the national insurance that is supposed to come into play, and I believe this is one of the key solutions to tackling the high healthcare costs.
All Ugandans, irrespective of age and employment status, will have to pay 15,000 shillings per year should the cabinet approve the proposed National Health Insurance Scheme bill. Commenting on the matter, the Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom Prime Minister said the government's intended health insurance is very expensive and some people cannot afford it. He has asked the government to revise it before it is passed into law.
The government attempting to come up with medical insurance. But medicine is expensive. I think there's some exploitation there which needs to be tackled. I don't know whether NDA, because you know, people regulate medicine in this country, and most of the medicine is imported. Why is it that expensive? You go for treatment, they give you a deal, $250,000. How can you afford that?
The ultimate goal of universal health coverage is to improve health outcomes by expanding access to essential healthcare services for all people in need and by ensuring that the people who seek access to healthcare services do not encounter excessive or undue financial hardship, according to the Ministry of Health. Story compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news in Hoima City.